This is a man who was true to himself and his principles right from the time he burst onto the scene to the time he died. This is an African leader. As he's lying down here today, we cannot talk of any secret bank account anywhere. We cannot talk of chains of houses anywhere in Ghana or abroad. That is the level of integrity. For somebody to have been in power for all these years, 19 years, and yet he didn't grab and amass wealth for himself, but focused on the development of the people, development of the country, the empowerment of the people. I think it's a great example to all of us and to the up-and-coming generation who are into politics or who want to aspire to go into politics. Now, politics is about empowering your society, is about giving back to your society, is about using the natural resources of the society to develop the country and not to ejapa and all those deals that African leaders have been doing to the detriment of the population.
Some have described him as a tyrant in the ways in which he carried out some of the activities while he was in power. For you, as somebody who has worked with him, who has been under his tutelage for all these years, what would you say to critics of the man who laid them motionless?
You know, leadership evolve and emerge as a response to the conditions in the society. If you recall, when the first set of firing squad were being done, do you remember what happened? People were at the firing range, cheering. University students were saying, "What? Let the blood flow." People had written all over the country, "Let the blood flow." If I had it not been for his leadership strength, many more people died or would have been executed. So it was a response to the environment, to the extent that ordinarily, when somebody is going to be executed, normal people will be sad. But people were so fed up with the rot and the corruption and misgovernance in the society that they cheered when their compatriots were being shot. That is how low the country had sunk. And to his credit, the same man, after 11 years, now decides that let's go the route of democracy. And then he ushered in the Fourth Republic. And the same man, after 8 years, unlike his compatriots all over, Mugabe, Museveni, all of them that you know, when he was in power, he had all the state apparatus, did not rig the election, but handed over peacefully. And that is why Ghana became a model of democracy. That is the legacy of the man we are talking about.
Finally, before I let you go, young politicians who are coming up, those who are even looking to have a career in politics, what are some of the key things they must learn from this man?
First of all, is the motive. Why do they want to come into politics? Do they want to come into politics because they want to amass wealth? They want to do deals like a japa and buy houses all over the place, both locally and abroad, for themselves, their family, or their girlfriends? Or they want to come into politics to serve? Because Rawlings came into politics to serve the society. He used the state power, state resources, and state machinery to develop the country. Extension of water and electricity and other social amenities to the rural areas. Empowering the people, the consciousness, the awareness, property, integrity, and accountability. These are values that have come to stay. So when people are coming into politics, we must be sure of the motive, that they are coming to serve and to use the state resources to help develop the nation and to help the ordinary people, not to amass wealth for themselves.